بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I am Walaa Baher, Assistant Professor of Histology and Cell Biology, Faculty of Medicine, Ain Shams University, and I am glad to present my poster project. My project title was Moving Basics of Stem Cell Biology and Culture Elective Course Online. Actually, the idea of this project emerged from its need. This course was given previously as a face-to-face course and encountered a lot of problems, including busy schedules for the faculty and the students, and limited resources allocated for the online courses. These factors led to failure of repetition of this course several times per academic year, and the student leakage from the course was very high. The objectives of my project divided into process objective and outcome objective. The process objective is to construct an operational framework for online course development based on conceptual validated frameworks. The outcome objective is to apply the developed operational framework in moving stem cell elective course offered by Histology and Cell Biology Department for undergraduate medical students in Faculty of Medicine, Ain Shams University. My methodology included two phases. Phase one was a theoretical phase in which in-depth literature reviewing was done, including the teaching, learning, and curriculum theories to adopt a well-structured, validated conceptual framework to build upon my operational framework. Finally, I adopted this enhanced e-learning framework after DiBattista, which included 10 main standards and was modified by adding an additional 8 specific standards by Daniels et al. Adopting this enhanced e-learning framework resulted in building my operational framework. My operational framework consisted of two levels. Level one, preparation phase, which was already done, and level two, in action phase, which is currently in process. Level one included 3 stages: initiation stage, planning stage, and execution stage, whereas level two including implementation and evaluation. And as you can see, each stage of the 5 stages included a number of tasks. By implementing these tasks and accomplishing these tasks, we can move the online course, we can move the face-to-face course to online successfully and ensure its sustainability. The outcomes after applying phase one, which was initiation, planning, and execution, resulted in one of the most important results, which was the evaluation plan. The evaluation plan was done adopting the CIPP model, which comprised 4 categories: context, input, process, and product. And in my evaluation plan, I identified the evaluation questions and mapped them against the evaluation methods and the evaluation indicators. And this evaluation plan will act as a base for identifying the areas of change and improvement in my project. Also, the outcomes included modifications done to the face-to-face course as regards the lecture numbers, the assessment, the grading rubrics, the course outline, the course evaluation, and the targeted students. The final conclusion after applying the level one was: moving courses online is not just uploading materials on a learning platform, yet it is challenging to translate what has already been done well in a face-to-face classroom into an online virtual classroom. However, adopting a well-structured framework for preparing, implementing, and evaluating the online courses is a mandatory step that leads to success and sustainability. Thank you.